Welcome, School of Media Arts Studies students, family, and friends. My name is Brian Plow, and I'm the interim director of the school, and I welcome you to this year's Scholarship Award celebration. Okay, never mind. Of course, we'd like to be doing this. I'll just keep it rolling. I'm going to do it over again. And are graduating and moving on to different places in the world and different professions and jobs. Welcome, School of Media Arts and Studies students, family, and friends. My name is Brian Plow. Keep it rolling. All right. Good, because this is gonna get bad if I start to get the giggles. Welcome, School of Media Arts and Studies students, family, and friends. My name is Brian Plow. I'm the interim director of the school, and I welcome you to this year's Scholarship Awards celebration. Of course, we'd like to be doing this in person, but this is the next best thing. And my thanks go out to Josh Antonuccio, Andy Walla, and the rest of the media faculty for pulling all of this together. This is an important moment for our students. Some of them being honored tonight have finished a very challenging year and have done so with excellence. And some are finishing 4 years with us and moving on to what's in store for them next in their professional lives. And we want to honor them as well. So thank you for honoring them with us. And without further ado, let's get on with the show.
Good evening. My name is Josh Antonuccio. I'm the chair of the Student and Alumni Relations Committee here in the School of Media Arts and Studies. On behalf of myself and all the faculty and staff here in the school, we want to extend a warm welcome to all the students, family members, and friends that are here with us tonight. Now, of course, this is not how we anticipated or ever dreamed that this is how our semester would end. If things had gone as we had planned, we would all be in Baker Center Ballroom tonight enjoying hors d'oeuvres and one another's company, but unfortunately that's not the case. Yet despite this difficult situation, myself and the faculty, we wanted to put together a special evening to help close out this unprecedented semester. So we come together virtually to celebrate our graduating seniors, award our student scholarship winners, and to recognize student excellence in creative work. We also want to let every student know that we in the School of Media Arts and Studies, we care deeply about you. We are so tremendously proud of all that you've accomplished and endured, and we're here to help and support you any way we can in this time of uncertainty. Tonight, we also want to recognize the outstanding creativity and entrepreneurial spirit found in our students, our student leaders, and our student organizations, and we're going to highlight some of their work from the semester throughout tonight's ceremony. One of the things that makes our school so unique and exciting is the collection of student organizations that provide Ohio University students with the opportunity to produce and create original work across their media area, and also to help them to network and connect with peers and industry professionals. These student organizations include Brick City Records, Rough Cut Collective, ACRN, Bobcat Productions, our Animation Club, the Ohio University Game Developers Association, the Audio Engineering Society, AVW, MBS, the OU Electronic Music Collective, the OU Immersive Media Association, and the Ohio University Women in the Music Industry Group. So, let's begin the evening by sharing one of the short films produced by our students during the 2020 48-hour shootout. This event gives students 2 days to write, direct, and perfect a short film. All creativity must take place within those 48 hours, including writing, rehearsals, costume, and set design. It's an incredible event that culminates with all of those films being presented to those that were involved. This was our 18th year of the event, with close to 20 teams and 150 student participants. So, here for you now is the short 4-minute film that was produced by the OU Animation Club for the 2020 48-hour shootout.
Hey, it's been a while. Well, not much has changed. I'm still head tiny chef.
Come here, tiny chef.
And Fettuccine is still an unfortunate, rat-dependent human.
Ready for the dinner rush? All right, let's get cracking then.
And everything was running smoothly until he showed up. And that's when everything went to shit.
Oh no.
Raw! 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 It's f***ing raw!
It's a carrot.
Did I ask? What is this?
Water?
Bland! This place is a godforsaken disaster. You've got flavorless carrots, your water's bloody cold, and you've got your line cook listening to f***ing music!
Respect the classics, man. It's Hendrix.
It's last night's dinner is what it is! Trash!
How dare he come in here and tear my kitchen apart? Does he know the first thing about cooking? What an absolute...
Is something wrong with your hat, pasta boy?
It's going down.
Oh, f***. I can't believe you've done this.
Emil?
Remy!
My brother? How could you?
I had to. You don't understand what I go through. Always outshined by my little brother. He said he could make me like you. Oh!
You think that's an excuse? You were my brother!
I was hungry. Hungry for cheesecake! But the cheesecake was a lie!
Join me. Join me, and we can fix this all.
Oh, it's cold as shit in here! At least give me a f***ing blanket!
Each year, we have the privilege of giving away over $60,000 in scholarship funding to our students in the School of Media Arts and Studies. We begin our awards portion tonight with a series of scholarships that are given out through the Scripps College of Communication. Here to announce those award winners is Greg Muller, Associate Dean of Student Success in the Scripps College of Communication.
Scripps College of Communication scholarships are awarded to talented students who make significant contributions to the School of Media Arts and Studies activities outside the classroom while demonstrating financial need and academic merit. This year's award goes to Megan Wolf and Matthew Porter. Megan studies integrated media and at this time would like to pursue editing, directing, and screenwriting. This year, she was nominated for the Ireland Study Abroad program. She works at WEB as a feature production assistant and also enjoys her time outside of class attending club meetings with Rough Cut Collective. At the beginning of the semester, her script was selected for a funded production with Rough Cut, which she hopes will begin production in the fall. Matthew. Matthew is a sophomore, integrated media major, who has been building his creative portfolio in his media classes and has a dream to create his own cartoon show. Throughout the year, he has been in a variety of creative projects and has created a board game, multiple stories, and a video, as well as a small number of animations. Congratulations. The Scripps College of Communication General Endowment. This year, awards go to Shane Casserly and Kaylee Shaw. Shane majors in games animation with a minor in studio art. He currently works at the Grid Lab on the Athemos project. He is a member of the Ohio University Animation Club and has participated in the past two 48-hour shootouts. He hopes to get a career in advertising as a 3D artist with an emphasis on realism. Kaylee shares that she is incredibly thankful for her time in the School of Media Arts and Studies and is excited to learn all she can in her last year, 2020 to 2021. Working at the Gaming Research Immersive Design Lab over the last year has been a pivotal experience in her life, and one which she would not have had the opportunity to participate in without the encouragement of the instructors in this school. Congratulations, Shane and Kaylee. The Scripps Anonymous Scholarship. This year's award go to Lauren Steinkuhl. Lauren is a screenwriting and producing major. She traveled to Ecuador with Infectious and Tropical Disease Institute last summer to create a social media campaign to raise money for their work to fight Chagas disease. She currently works for the Grid Lab on their 360-degree video team. She is involved with Blue Pencil Comedy as well. Congratulations. The Scripps College of Communication Multicultural Enhancement Award. This award is presented to a student of diverse background. This year's award goes to Devens Fajardo. Devens is a music production recording industry major. Throughout his time at The Ohio University in the music production program, he has created two EPs along with 10 singles. Within these years, he has accumulated over 250,000 streams, opening doors for him to perform at festivals like Numbers Fest and Breakaway Music Festival. He's met a lot of musicians at this school and has been able to work with a few which have influenced his music. Congratulations, Devens. The Weiss-Mulgrew Family Scholarship. This year's award goes to Alexis Murray. Alexis is a music production major in the media school and has loved every minute of it. She is an ambassador for Scripps frequently speaks to prospective media students about attending Ohio University. She is also a digital communication assistant for Advancement Communication Marketing and a learning community leader. She worked with Jeff Redifer and Dean Titsworth to get a piano for the school recording studio in 2019. Alexis serves on the Experiential Learning Student Advisory Board for OU. She's had an internship with Covert Creative in New York City last summer. She studied abroad with the Screenwriting and Documentary Storytelling Program in Spain through Media. She's volunteered at the National Turnip Gold Gala in Houston, performed in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade with the Marching 110, and traveled with the Ohio University Multimedia Society to New York City, to DC for networking trips, and many more. She's an active member in the student organization Women in the Music Industry, and recently received the Mary Elizabeth Lasher Burnett Women's Leadership Award through the E.W. Scripps School of Journalism, as well as being inducted into the Dean's Leadership Circle earlier this year. Congratulations, Lexi Murray. And now, back to you, Josh.
School of Media Arts and Studies is proud to have its own record label, Brick City Records. And the label actually also serves as the capstone class for all of our music production and recording industry majors. Full disclosure, I help oversee this talented group of students each year. It's one of my favorite classes to teach and to watch the passion and creativity of these students flourish. Each year, the students in the label scout and sign four regional artists to produce and then release music for. In partnership with Andy Walla's Integrated Media students, the class develops a music video for a single from each of the artists on the roster. This year represented another successful collaboration, and we are thrilled to share this video that they produced for the new single by RJ Martin, an aspiring and talented musician right here in the School of Media Arts and Studies. Enjoy.
Thank you. like the memories in my brain. You promised me no more close calls ever again. I wish you could come and tell me that you had told me so. Oh, for now I'll sit and watch and wait for those flowers to grow. The snowy branches crumble underneath all of the weight. The ice beneath my feet has become too thin to skate. There's a chilling resolve on the end of all of your words. I could stay and talk for just a while, my voice will go unheard. I hide away in here for just another moment. Myself and cry without them ever knowing.
Our next awards portion will focus on scholarship awards presented by our own media faculty for students across major areas in our school. I will be starting tonight's media awards by announcing the recipients of two scholarships in the School of Media Arts and Studies. I begin first with the Christine Twardzik Memorial Scholarship. Christine Twardzik was a senior video production major when she died in a car accident in 2006. Christine was active in Fridays Live and the weekly show Streetwalking. She was a producer on the shows and led with an always-present smile and laughter. The Twardzik family created a scholarship in her name. This award goes to a Media Arts and Studies senior with a minimum GPA of 3.0. This year's award goes to two students, Maria Breckenridge and Savannah Copeland. Maria Breckenridge is an integrated media major and says that the Media Arts and Studies program here at Ohio University has made such an impact and influence on her future career. She shares that she is very confident in her abilities to get a really good career, and she'd like to thank two media professors that have really influenced her heart and ambition for digital storytelling, Andy Walla and Roger Cooper. Savannah Copeland is an integrated media major who shares that she would not be where she is today without the incredible clubs and professors that have helped her. She'd like to thank Fridays Live, the Women's Comedy Show, the Margaret Boyd Scholars Program, the Grid Lab, Lantern Light Studios, and the Athens International Film and Video Festival. Additionally, she thanks Roger Cooper, David Colagiovanni, David Thomas, Patty McSteen, Anthony Zicola, and Eric Williams for giving her opportunities that have helped her immensely in her journey at Ohio University. The second award I'll be presenting is the Philip E. Schmidt Broadcasting Scholarship. Philip Schmidt was a 1950 graduate of the radio television program who had a successful career in broadcasting. He specialized in radio, and his best memories of campus center around the radio station that was then housed in an old Army Quonset hut where Alden Library now stands. This award goes to a junior or senior with academic merit and a focus on broadcasting. We have three recipients this year: Katie Brown, Elijah Jimenez, and Catherine Summer. Kate Brown is an integrated media major and has been a member of AVW Studios for 3 semesters and counting. Through AVW, she has been able to help create so many short films and even direct or produce a few of them. She's also a student staff member at the LGBT Center and has been creating graphics, posters, and YouTube videos for them for the past academic year. Elijah Jimenez has spent more than 700 hours working on film sets as a director of photography, gaffer, camera assistant or grip, and in post-production as a video editor while at Ohio University. He has worked with incredible film production organizations such as Rough Cut Collective, AVW Studios, and 419 Productions. He is currently employed on campus at the Grid Lab, where he is a student leader on the 360 video team. Elijah has also recently been accepted into the upcoming Ohio NLA fall program. Catherine Summer is pursuing a major in integrated media, a minor in political science, and certifications in social media and political communications. She uses her out-of-class time through multiple organizations on campus. She is a Lynx peer mentor through the Office of Multicultural Student Access and Retention, co-director of Bobcat Productions Presents Ohio Hockey, alumna relations chair through the Alpha Delta Pi sorority, and a new member of AVW Productions as of this past semester. Previously, she held a graphics internship for the committee to elect Brett Shriver, social media production internship for the Core Builder Pro Company, and this past semester was an intern at the Athens County Prosecutor's Office. And now, here to present our remaining awards are the esteemed faculty in the School of Media Arts and Studies.
Hi, I'm Steve Howard, and I'm happy to present the Lyon Family Scholarship. This is awarded through the Scripps College of Communication to an exceptional MDIA student, and this year the award goes to Macy Wright. Macy is a member of 2 clubs, JMAGE and Bobcat Tabletop. She's also involved in Lynx and will be a peer mentor next year. She also works ringside at Bird Arena. Congratulations, Macy.
Jeffrey Chaddock graduated from the College of Communication with a Bachelor of Science in Information and Telecommunications Systems, known as Communication Systems Management, in 1988. He is currently a financial advisor with the Chaddock Group, an Ameriprise financial services firm with offices in Athens and Gahanna, Ohio. He is on the board of the Ohio University Foundation and was named one of the top 1,000 advisors in Barron's in 2013. This scholarship is awarded to an Athens campus student majoring in any of the 5 schools within the Scripps College with a minimum 3.0 GPA and having completed 30 hours by the end of spring semester of their freshman year. They must have demonstrated leadership abilities. This year's award goes to Austin Alford. For the past year, Austin has worked in the Grid Lab as a VR/AR assistant. He's also served as the animation and sound design lead and editor for the Animation Club's 48-hour shoot-up entry. Additionally, Austin recently became the social media management of the Animation Club and is a member of the Alpha Lambda Delta Honor Society. Congratulations to Austin.
Hello, I'm Wolfgang Sützel from the School of Media Arts and Studies, and I'm here to present the David C. Mitchell Scholarship in Communication. The David C. Mitchell Scholarship in Communication is awarded to a student exhibiting excellence. And this year's winner is Mike Piercy. Mike Piercy is a music production recording industry major. He has been very involved in the MDIA school producing and mixing songs for himself as well as for others. Congratulations, Mike Piercy.
Created in 1986, the Archie Gerr Scholarship was established by Archie's many students in recognition of his outstanding leadership as a professor in our program. He filled many roles at Ohio University, once serving as program director of WOUB Radio. He is credited with contributing to the development of the TECOM program, the School of Telecommunications, and was the first director of the school, then known as the School of Radio Television, when the College of Communication was formed. He was a strong supporter and the original and longtime faculty advisor of the All-Campus Radio Network, known as ACRN. Archie passed away a few years ago, having lived a full life that influenced many, many Ohio University graduates. This year's winner is Kaiya Easton. Kaiya is an MPRI major who says that ACRN has been one of the most influential things to be part of. He's involved in editorial as the columns editor, promo as contact point and a general helper booking shows every year, and in production as a helping hand contributing to each in the ACRN studios and as a DJ on the air. Acting as columns editor for ACRN editorial has taught Kaiya basic skills such as leadership as well as specific nuances to editing and the column format. His duties in this role include pitching column ideas to writers, editing columns, and communicating with staff writers and other ACRN executives in order to put columns on the ACRN website in a timely manner. Congratulations, Kaiya Easton.
Hey, Bobcats. First of all, congratulations. You've made it through another year. And what a year. Let's face it, this must suck for you guys, staying away from your classes in Athens and your friends. But the good news is, through all this, you're going to have your friends. Take it from me. The friends that you make in Athens are super special people. So let's talk about the award. Now, I'm supposed to say this part. Named posthumously for the audio graduate Doug Hill, the award is presented to a junior with specialization in radio, television production, performance, and writing, someone who is actively involved in professional media work outside of class. Now, all that's true. Let's talk about Doug, though. If you ask Doug's friends about him, they'll say things like Doug Hill was a bright, creative person, and he was laid back and funny and probably goofed off too much in class. After college, he worked in radio and television and in advertising. And when he got sick, who did we call in the middle of the night? Our friends from OU. And they helped us through his journey. And then when we lost him, those same friends from OU started this scholarship, hoping that the bright light that he had will continue through one of you. So that's the kind of friends Bobcats make. Now, I want you to think for a moment about all the friends you're calling now and realize that in 25 years, these folks are going to be your old friends. So there's a lot of life left for you guys to share together. And in that spirit, it's now my honor to announce the recipient of what I like to call the Friends of Doug Hill Scholarship. And this year's winner is Devin Latour. Devin is a rising junior majoring in integrated media while minoring in journalism. She is the director of the sketch comedy group Fridays Live, and she's active in the film club Rough Cut Collective. In addition, she assists graduate students on film sets. In the past, she's operated cameras for OUB, and she's a member of Phi Sigma Pi National Honor Fraternity. Very impressive, Devin. Devin would like to thank Evan Shaw for allowing her to tag along on his shoots for his upcoming Our Town documentary about Galapagos. And I'd like to thank you, Devin, for being that bright light. You make us proud.
Hi, Media Arts and Studies students. It's my pleasure to announce the Larry and Joanne Katz Award. The Larry and Joanne Katz Award goes to a media student exhibiting academic excellence and leadership as a creative professional. This year, the Larry and Joanne Katz Award goes to Nate Hervey. Nate is a music production major and has been involved in regional music projects. With the media school, he has been able to work in studio recordings with bands from Athens and beyond. He was selected to attend the Media Masterclass series in Austin, Texas this past December to learn from Jim Eno. He also loves to write short stories, films, and music. Congratulations, Nate, and congratulations to all our media students, not just for the awards this evening, but for persevering through this unpredictable semester.
Hi, this is Leigh Kahn, and I will be presenting the Tyler Weymouth Memorial Scholarship. The Tyler Weymouth Memorial Scholarship recognizes a media student demonstrating academic and creative excellence in the School of Media Arts and Studies. This year's recipient is William Jackson. William Jackson is an integrated media major who has worked in a number of productions at Ohio University, including sports productions for college events broadcast through ESPN Plus and ESPN3. Congratulations, William.
Hello, everyone. My name is Samya Pant. Ellen Woodward was an audio production major in the school and one of the first women to select audio as her area of emphasis. She was a junior in the program when she was killed in an automobile accident. To perpetuate her memory, her family established the scholarship in her name to be awarded to a junior or senior majoring in audio production. This year's recipient of the Ellen Woodward Memorial Scholarship is Miranda Ewell. Congratulations. Miranda Ewell is a games and animation major and a freelance designer and caricature artist. She has held caricature positions at Cayman's Art Shop and the Village Flea in Monroeville, Ohio as well, as freelanced several other projects. She served on the Voight Hall Council and was the president of the Ohio University Roller Coaster Enthusiasts student organization. She plans to do the storytelling in theme parks course in the fall. Congratulations, Miranda.
Hi, I'm pleased to present the Nationwide Foundation Scholarships to five students. Nationwide Communications first radio station signed on the air in 1946, and during its time in the radio industry, it grew to become the 16th largest radio group in the country, operating 17 stations in 8 high-growth markets. The Nationwide Foundation made this gift to the School of Media Arts and Studies to leave a legacy recognizing its 5 decades in the radio industry to support an institution to which it has grown closely tied to for more than 40 years and to demonstrate its commitment to education. The scholarship supports students who will be engaging in internships in the coming year. And this year we have 5 recipients. They're all excellent people and students, and I'm very pleased to announce them. Katie Bugos is a major in music production and recording industry. Kristen Borowski, a major in games and animation. Maria Breckenridge, a major in integrated media. Savannah Copeland, a major in screenwriting and producing. And Jenna Prosser, a major in screenwriting and producing. Again, these are 5 fantastically deserving students who are going to be really successful in their careers. And I want to congratulate all 5 for receiving the Nationwide Scholarship.
The Long Family Scholarship is awarded through the Scripps College of Communication to a media student exhibiting academic excellence. This award goes to Gray Longfellow. Gray has had the wonderful opportunity to record multiple groups, including a stage musical cast within the media studio. They've done sound mixing, underscore, and sound design for student films with AVW Studios and credit for voiceover engineering in an independent documentary. Currently, Gray works as a live recording engineer with the School of Music to archive student, faculty, and guest performances. Congratulations, Greg.
The Thomas H. Strike Memorial Scholarship was established in honor of Tom Strike, who graduated from OU in 1978 with a degree in audio production. This award recognizes the achievements, promise, and potential of a junior or senior in the audio sequence. This year's recipients are Nate Saar and Michael Boston. first a little bit about Nate. Nate Saar is a music production and recording industry student and a member of the 2019-2020 Brick City Records team. He's a musician as well as a producer and recently released a full-length album under the artist name Fragile Sun. He was honored to participate in the 2019 New York City Mixing Masterclass with Michael Brower this past fall, and he's also a part of the Honors Tutorial College, and has been working with other HTC students from dance and visual art to create collaborative interdisciplinary artistic projects. Moving on now to the second recipient, Michael Boston. Michael is a music production and recording industry major. He writes and performs regularly and recently released music through the student record label Brick City Records. He shares that, in his words, "College of Communication has opened my eyes to multiple opportunities that I'm able to pursue. I could not be more grateful for this. I've learned that there is a whole community behind me in my endeavors, and I owe this to Ohio University, but more specifically to the MPRI program. I want to give thanks to the entire university for not only awarding me this scholarship, but for setting me up to be successful in whatever path I take. Congratulations to you both, Nate and Michael." The Leonard E. Auerbach Regional Reps Corporation Scholarship is awarded to a junior or senior interested in broadcasting advertising sales, especially radio. Founded in 1956 and originally named Ohio Stations Representatives, Regional Reps is the oldest and largest radio station sales representative firm in Ohio, specializing in small and medium markets. It's also one of the oldest and largest in the country, with offices in Cleveland, Cincinnati, Atlanta, Chicago, Dallas, and New York. This year's Leonard E. Auerbach Regional Reps Corporation Scholarship goes to Katie Bugos. A little bit about Katie. Katie Bugos is a music production and recording industry major. She currently holds leadership positions at ACRN, WIMI, and the Athena Cinema. She was accepted into the 2020 South by Southwest program, as well as the Bonnaroo Fort Castle Music Industry Masterclass. She recently received a position as a marketing intern at Live Nation Entertainment this summer in Cleveland. It's great news, and congratulations to you, Katie.
Hi out there. The Robert Coe Scholarship was established in memory of former ABC executive Bob Coe. Bob, a pioneer in the television industry, also served on our faculty from 1967 until 1973. This scholarship is awarded to an undergraduate student with an interest in broadcast engineering or broadcast management. This award is also based on academic merit. This year's Robert L. Coe Scholarship goes to Jillian Fout. Jillian is heavily involved with ACRN and WIMI, opportunities which she says have substantially changed her relationships and career. She adds that she is incredibly thankful and grateful to be ACRN's promo director and WIMI's social media coordinator. Thank you to my family, friends, and professors who have supported me throughout my college years. Congratulations, Jillian.
Joseph Mickey Franco was a 1967 graduate of Ohio University's College of Business. He spent his career in the radio business, becoming the manager of radio operations for Nationwide Communications, overseeing 16 radio stations. The scholarship was established by Nationwide in Mickey's memory and is awarded to a senior active in radio and management. This year's awardee is Vicki Swift. Vicki's active in WOUB and directs live broadcasts like Newswatch and Gridiron Glory. She also attended the screenwriting and documentary storytelling in Ireland program this past summer and produced a script about the relationship between archaeology and folklore in Ireland. While working at the Scripps College Equipment Room, she loves to educate new students about media and equipment. Congratulations, Vicki.
I'm very pleased to present the first Patricia Butcher Cooper Ohio and LA Scholarship. Pat was really instrumental in the creation of the Ohio and LA program. And when I got the opportunity to start an LA program about 6.5 years ago, I knew that this had the potential to really upend our lives, but Pat could not have been more supportive or encouraging of doing the program. And she was instrumental throughout, working here in Athens while I was out in LA, coming out to LA in the summer, going on excursions with students. She really loved being involved in the program, and it meant so much to me. I want to tell you two things about Pat. One is that paying for college was a big issue for her when she was in college. She graduated with her bachelor's in 2.5 years, and part of that was because she was really smart, but part of it, and really the main reason, was because she was always worried about running out of money. So last year on her birthday, June 25th, unfortunately, she had to go to the James emergency room in Columbus because of a bad reaction to chemotherapy. And we spent the entire day in the emergency room. Finally, early on the 26th, she got a room in the hospital, and I gave her a birthday card. And it was kind of a normal birthday card, but inside the card was another card telling her that my mom and I had created an endowment for her scholarship. And I can't tell you how moved she was by that. She was so surprised, characteristic of her. She was just so humbled by it, but so deserving of it. And I'm so thankful that I was able to let her know how much she meant to the program in that kind of way, while she could still be here and really appreciate all that she has done for the LA program. The second thing I want to tell you is that if you were to speak with Pat for about 5 seconds, you would know she's from the South, but her values are pure Midwest all the way. And so as I work with students in LA, these really wonderful students who are doing such special things or on their way to doing so, I see Pat in them, and it only encourages me more to work to help students develop and become all that they can be in the industry or whatever it is that they are passionate about. I also want to give a quick thank you to the 25 people who have donated to the scholarship, who have built up the endowment. These are former LA program students, peers, colleagues, family, friends, really grateful for that, so that we can provide a really substantial scholarship for students who participate in the LA program. A special thank you to Lynn Butcher Wilson, Pat's sister, and Kyle Bowser, who was also instrumental in starting the program, for providing an initial donation, which would allow us to provide a scholarship from year one so that we don't have to wait for it to become vested. And I'm very pleased to announce that Meredith Wamas is the first recipient of the Patricia Butcher Cooper Ohio and LA Scholarship. Meredith is a fantastic student, a wonderful person. Pat would have absolutely loved her, and she is going to be so, so successful. She's interested in sound production and audio post. She works in sound in a variety of ways, film, music, games, and theater. She's a member of the Audio Engineering Society and treasurer of the Ohio University Multimedia Association. She will be in the fall LA program. And again, I could not be more thrilled to give this award to Meredith Wamas.
Another aspect of what makes our school so special are the visiting artists and professionals that come to campus to engage with our students. Each year, we host incredible programming with national leaders in the media and music industries, including the Ohio University Music Industry Summit, our Spring Communication Week, and the Scripps Visiting Artist Series hosted by NPR Music's Bob Boylan. These events are special for our students, bringing well-known leaders to campus and providing a direct connection for networking and education. We had a lot of great events planned for this spring, and sadly, because of the campus closure, most of these highly anticipated events were canceled. I'm pleased to say that here tonight, one of those speakers is here to share a short keynote with our students. Would you please join me in welcoming the host and creator of NPR Music's famed Tiny Desk Concert Series, Bob Boylan.
Hey there, students, graduating seniors. I'm Bob Boylan. You might know me from Tiny Desk Concerts, my desk at NPR in Washington. Today I'm at my desk at home, as many of us are, and I make music in my house, and I also record my podcast in my home right here. And it's hard for me to imagine ever being one to give advice of any sort. When I think of myself as a 20-something year old, I was a person who went to college for 5.5 years and never graduated. I couldn't find what I loved in college all through college. I did work 48 hours a week in record stores, and that was my passion, but I didn't think that was something that you go and make money in, that is music. I didn't think that having a passion is how you found a way in your life to make a living. That wasn't how I was brought up. But about the age of 27, being frustrated and not doing what I loved, I chucked it all and bought a synthesizer and joined a band called Tiny Desk Unit. It was an awfully long time ago. And still, in fact, a text message just came on my screen from that very guitarist, Michael Barron, from Tiny Desk Unit. We still make music together, and we're working on yet another album, this one for the month of April. There's something called the RPM Challenge, and in a given month, we make an album from the first of the month to the end of the month. And it's taught me something. A lesson that has come up quite a number of times in my life. Well, first, to pursue what you love, which may be your generation, my son's generation, your generation, may be more obvious than it was for my generation, but do that, because that's key. But the other part of all of that is take chances, which is really, really an important thing to do and to understand when to do it when you're younger and don't have a family and other larger obligations. Taking chances is easier, so do those chances now. Don't be discouraged when it comes to your dreams. It's really, really important to pursue those things that you love. Be a good listener. One thing to be headstrong and have a dream. It's also good to hear the wisdom of others. It doesn't mean you have to take all their advice, but sometimes they'll have an insight into you that you might not have. I went up at NPR, not a day in journalism, not a day in radio. I went to my favorite show that had done a story on my music years ago, and that show was All Things Considered. I told them I wanted to work there. It's a longer story than I can tell here, but be that as it may, I wound up being, I got a job from week to week, sort of, cutting tape back in those days at All Things Considered. And I had an opportunity, and someone said to me, because someone was leaving, "Bob, you ought to direct that show." And I said, I can't do that. But they saw in me my love for music, which was important to directing a music show, important to directing a new show, that the knowledge of music was important in the pacing of the show and so forth. And so someone else saw in me something that I didn't know I had. Listening for that is important, and I took that job on, and I wound up directing All Things Considered for 18, 19 years, something I madly wound up loving to do. But I want to speak also to these times, because we're living right now in a time where it feels like there's strict limitations on what you can do. Certainly, those are truths, but it doesn't mean they're roadblocks. The one thing I've learned, and this goes back to making that record in a month, it goes back to bringing bands to my desk, doing Tiny Desk Concerts, that when you limit a creative person, it is a spark to different solutions. And so when I tell a group, hey, I'm not gonna amplify the voice of your lead singer, those guitarists go, and yet they wind up playing and listening to one another more carefully and making something they never would have made before. And that's the beauty of it. And that's the beauty of limitations. Creative people come up with solutions when you are limited. The idea that all possible things are best to have so you can pick the ones you like, that for at least in me in my life hasn't been true. Having limits placed upon us gives rise to the creative spirit. And I want you to think about that as you go forward. I've been to your school and done shows and concerts and talks, and I know what Josh has put together there and how he inspires creativity. Don't lose sight of that. Be well. Have great lives. If you make music, send it to me. And trust in yourself. Take care. Thanks.
Along with our undergraduate awards, we will also be announcing some of our graduate student award winners. Here to present is media professor Steve Howard.
Thank you for the opportunity to include our graduate student paper competition in this unique online event. Although I wish I'd had a chance to get my hair cut before I made a video of myself. We had an intense competition, and we had three winners. We selected three winners for this year's prizes. The three are Agri Otieno. His paper is entitled From Pandemic to Social Media Infodemic, Framing of Health Messaging in an Era of Mass Misinformation. Sami Bedir. His paper is entitled Exploring Local, Experimenting with Transnational, Producing Turkish Television Series. And Deniza Mulaj, her paper is entitled Rethinking Spatiality in Media, A Framing Analysis of the U.S. Media and the Conflict in Mitrovica. So congratulations to all, and thanks very much.
As you've seen tonight, the School of Media Arts and Studies is a special place. As interim director, I am privileged to help lead this community of smart, creative, talented, and thoughtful students and faculty who are passionate about their work. Each year, the faculty selects a graduating senior who has demonstrated strong academic performance and exceptional involvement outside the classroom to receive our Outstanding Senior Award. It is a special honor. This year will be the first time that we've had a tie, and as a result, we'll be awarding this to two individuals. The 2019-2020 School of Media Arts and Studies Outstanding Seniors are Michaela Chelinski and Elizabeth Coleman. During Michaela Chelinski's time at Ohio University, she has had the great opportunity to serve as the student manager of the Scripps College Equipment Room, a board member of OU's Audio Engineering Society, the president and production manager of the Los Flamingo Theater Company, and participate in the 48-hour shootout all 4 years of her college career. Last summer, she had the amazing experience of being a part of the Ohio and LA program and interning with Sony Pictures Entertainment. She will be moving to LA in August to begin a career in the film industry. And now a word about Elizabeth Coleman. Elizabeth is an MPRI major who has held positions in the equipment room and as a recording engineer for the School of Music. She shares that she has been able to incorporate such experiences as a semester in Berlin and participation in the ensembles in the School of Music into her life as a music production student. She's especially grateful to the HTC program and her professors Beth Novak, Josh Antonuccio, Eddie Ashworth, and Drew McDaniel in the Media School, and to Dr. Michelle Fiala in the School of Music for their impact on her as a person and as a student. Congratulations to Michaela and Elizabeth. Thank you very much.
For the final awards portion of this evening, we will be announcing a series of student recognition awards curated by our director and handpicked by the media faculty. Here to announce these awards is School of Media Arts and Studies Director Brian Plow.
The Director's Awards of Excellence recognize both outstanding academic performance and a dedication to developing professional skills through experience outside the classroom. We have many exceptional students who, through discipline and commitment, are laying the foundation for a successful career. This year's recipients will be introduced via video by the faculty who have nominated them.
I'm so happy to nominate Kay Germer for an MDIA Director's Award. Kay is a media and social science major, and she's always exemplified a deep critical approach to media. At the same time, she has really excellent production skills, which I have seen both in the queer theory class that she took with me in spring 2019, and the media and sexual representation class that she's taking with me right now. Kay, your 4.0 GPA is amazing, but also just the depth of engagement that you've shown in classes with really complex material, and also being able to bring your own kind of personal perspectives as a student, as a media producer, has been really amazing to watch and to experience. So congratulations. I'm really happy to nominate Maddie Kelly for an MDIA Director's Award. Maddie has been a standout student in my media and sexual representation class. It's clear to me that you're one of the few students that has actually done the readings every class. And then more than that, the things that you say in class as well as your written work have been insightful, excellently expressed, and show that you are not just sort of going through the motions, but you're deeply engaged with the questions that I want you to be thinking about. I'm really impressed by the breadth of your studies, so not just your integrated media major, but also your English minor and your Asian studies and diversity studies certificates. I'm sure you're going to go really amazing places, and happy graduation in this weirdest of semesters.
It's my pleasure to give out the next pair of director's awards. First up is Riley Zink. Riley is an HTC student focusing on immersive media, and she completed an internship this summer with NASA. She also worked at the Grid Lab and is completing a thesis about augmented reality. Riley, I really appreciate your enthusiasm and can-do spirit and your baked goods, and you were wonderful to have around the last 4 years. Next Director's Award goes to Alyssa Stahl. Alyssa is also an HTC student studying immersive media, also worked at the Grid Lab, and she completed an internship this past summer at Siemens Corporation for Communications. She is completing a thesis highlighting her interest in virtual reality and psychology. Alyssa, I've really seen you grow to become more confident over the last 4 years, and I'm really hopeful that you know that you are awesome, just like everyone around you knows that. And thanks for keeping me up to date on all the memes. I don't know how I'll be cool after you graduate. I'd like to take a moment to shout out all four of our HTC seniors this year. Each of you has been an amazing part of our HTC community, and I'm really proud not just of what you've accomplished over the last 4 years, but really of the people that you are. So congratulations.
Hi everyone, I'm Kate Rainey. I first want to say congratulations to all the students receiving scholarships tonight and to the students receiving Director's Awards on the Outstanding Senior Award. I'm presenting Director's Awards for two exceptional students in the Games and Animation track. The first is Iris Edmondson. Since coming to OU, Iris has been active in UCTA and is currently the Vice President. She minored in Japanese and did a study abroad trip in Japan last summer. She also works at Culinary Services and has been a mentor at the Office of Multicultural Student Access. She makes primarily 2D artwork, which is lovely and whimsical, showing her playful sense of humor. She's an excellent student and a thoughtful human being. The second student is Sean Collins. Sean is primarily a game maker. At OU, he's worked as a laboratory technician for the Grid Lab and spent last summer in LA, where he interned for Exceptional Minds. He's also done work for Lantern Light Studios. Sean always pushes himself technically and creatively. In Animation 1, he used a wide variety of advanced effects and techniques to achieve the aesthetic he wanted for his project. He also always has a positive attitude and is generally an exceptional student. Thanks, Iris and Sean, for being such amazing students.
Hi, I'm Drew McDaniel, and my choice for a director's award is Gray Longfellow. Gray is an MPRI major who has very broad interests. They're working on a minor in business administration while also performing their role as producer, editor, director, and mixer of music performance recordings. One faculty colleague called them a quiet overachiever. And Gray is quiet. They would sit in my class in the front row, directly in front of me, always attentive and interested. And I loved that because it kept me on task, and I was sure that at least one person in the classroom was interested in what I was talking about. I think Gray only asked one question in the entire semester, but on exam day, they would knock it out of the park. Gray has a reputation for skillfully managing the producer's role in studio productions. They put performers at ease in the sometimes uncomfortable studio setting while staying on task in a highly professional manner. And this is the part I particularly like, Gray does not mind getting their hands dirty. This photo shows their project for my Media Tech lab this semester. It was built from scratch, identifying and soldering each and every little piece on this PC board, and I think it'll be great. For all these reasons, I think Gray deserves a big, big shout out, and of course, a director's award. Congratulations, Gray. Nice work.
Sound mixer, post-production audio, boom operator, producer, editor, videographer, manager, theater production, as well as electronics engineer and designing are just a few resume items for one of this year's Director's Award winners, Michaela Chelinski. I've had the privilege of working with Michaela in traditional classes as well as tutorials, and this semester on her final Honors Tutorial College thesis project. This project has Michaela in the role of producer, researcher, editor, sound designer, director, as well as using her substantial skills as a recording engineer. The project is a series of podcasts telling the stories of the supernatural tales surrounding Athens County. The podcast will soon be available on several audio streaming services. She has excelled at so many things related to media and the arts that it's impossible to list them here tonight. Not only does Michaela have tremendous talent and passion for creating compelling audio and video projects, she's discovered during her time with us that she's also a pretty darn good electronics technician. In both my studio design class and Drew McDaniel's technical basis class, she easily grasped the concepts of electronics and was able to research and construct some very nice projects. I'm thrilled to recognize Michaela Chelinski's successes at OU with one of this year's Director's Awards. Congratulations, Michaela.
Hi, I would like to nominate Nicholas Ruenkamp for Director's Award. Nick is a fantastic student, fantastic person, heavily involved in the school and university activities. And I want to tell you a little bit about Nick. He was in the Fall Ohio and LA program, had two internships, one as an audience coordinator with the Late Late Show with James Corden, and also worked as an entertainment PR intern for A-List Communications. He's had another internship prior to the LA program. He is involved in at the university level in admissions, a big promoter of media arts and studies, worked at AVW Studios on Fridays Live, has a 3.97 GPA. But I think the thing that made me most think about Nick is that Nick is kind of like the ultimate energy giver. He is extremely positive, always brings up the level of feeling in the group, and he's going to be one of these people that people really want to be around and want to work with. He's highly competent. He always gives his best. He's always positive, and he always does the right thing. So I'm quite pleased to nominate Nick for the Director's Award.
This next Director's Award goes to Lindsay Sierra. Lindsay has had an awesome career as an integrated media major. In her early years, she participated in 419 Productions, and she's also been an active student producer for the 48-hour shootout competition. Lindsay had the opportunity to participate in the Ohio and LA program last semester, out on the left coast, as I would say, and is going to be participating in the Miss Universe pageant internship on the right coast, as I'd like to say, in New York City here coming up. Lindsay is just an outstanding production student. I've had her not only in the classroom, but just working alongside her on personal projects or 48-hour shootout. She's just a very reliable student, and I know she's going to make us proud as she heads out into the real world. Congratulations, Lindsay, and it's just been a pleasure to watch you grow and flourish here as a student over the past 4 years. So, congratulations.
Hello again, I'm Brian Plow, Interim Director of the school, and my nomination this year for the Director's Award goes to Juwan Tai. Juwan is a senior integrated media major, and I remember Juwan from the first time he stepped foot on campus with Bobcat Student Orientation, and he's been one of my favorite students to work with ever since then. Juwan oftentimes comes to my office hours to ask me how I'm doing and what I'm up to, and he's very caring, generous, empathetic, and devoted student and person, and amongst my favorite students to work with. And one of the hardest working students that I've worked with over the last few years, oftentimes working two jobs while going to school full time to be able to afford his education and to also afford a summer in Los Angeles to develop and establish his career as a filmmaker and screenwriter. So it is my honor to honor Juwan Tai for this year's Director's Award. Thank you, Juwan, for 3 great years and all my best wishes for a bright future.
My selection for Director's Award this year is Reese Clutter. Reese is extremely driven and exceptionally skillful at his craft. He's the best kind of future music production professional, the sort of person who stays up late, sweating the details on how to best capture a complex ensemble the next day, and then, of course, as a result, nails it. He was at the center of our recent recording collaboration with Dr. Rob McClure's composition majors in the School of Music, many of whom chose to work with him afterwards on future projects. He also worked closely with our students, along with those in the School of Theater, in recording one of their musical productions in the MDIA recording studio. And of course, he tears it up recording rock bands. And bonus points for making a cool microphone out of a coffee can in Jeff Redifer's studio design and maintenance course. So congratulations, Reese. I know you will go far.
We'll close the Director's Award portion of this evening with two students that I selected for Director's Awards this year. The first is Maya Narayal. She is a music production and recording industry major and one of the finest students I've had the pleasure of working with. Before graduation, she has already held multiple leadership positions in the music industry through Director of Festival Activations and Decor for Prime Social Group, and has held an exclusive A&R internship position with Mom and Pop Records in New York City. She is this year's president of Brick City Records, a leader in Ohio University's Women in Music Industry organization, and attended last year's South by Southwest trip. I know great things will come from Maya's work in the music industry and beyond. The second student is Matt Dugan, a creative and aspiring music producer and artist. Matt exhibits a constant drive for excellence and a passion for producing exceptional music. Matt was accepted into this year's South by Southwest trip and was only one of five students selected to attend the exclusive Music Mixing Masterclass in New York City this past November with seven-time Grammy winner Michael Brower. Additionally, he was also accepted into the Music Production Masterclass in Austin, Texas with Spoon producer and drummer Jim Eno. He was a team leader and a key producer at Brick City Records this year and was involved in the Ohio and LA program last summer where he held an exclusive studio internship. Congratulations to all our Directors Award winners. Even in the midst of this crisis, our Media Arts and Studies students have been finding ways to flourish creatively and are using technology to continue to pursue their passions despite these trying circumstances. Two of those students are Bailey Panzeca and Taylor Swan, who performed together in the band Women. As with many of our students, they've been creating remotely and are here tonight to perform their song, Billy Bob's Psychological Adventure. Please welcome Bailey and Taylor.
Desperate times, wasted, struggle to find reasons or some kind of sign.
Thank all of you for joining us tonight. The faculty of the School of Media Arts and Studies would like to close our ceremony by celebrating all of our graduating seniors. With commencement postponed, We are going to be sharing all of our names of our graduating seniors in the School of Media Arts and Studies, and no, I will not be reading them by hand. Each of you should be proud of your accomplishment, and from each of us, we send our most heartfelt congratulations for this achievement. One of those graduates, Katie Stegmeier, also known as DJ Cookie, will be performing along with our announcement of graduates. And here in the school, we are privileged to host many exclusive global opportunities trips, including South by Southwest, Ohio and LA, documentary storytelling in Ireland, and our storytelling technology and theme parks experience, to name just a few. One class that runs in the summer is our Music Industry Masterclass, which brings students to work on site and backstage at two major US music festivals, one of which is Bonnaroo Music and Arts Festival. Now, last year, Katie was one of the students selected for that trip and was given the opportunity to close the last night of Bonnaroo with a DJ set at Haley Williams Plaza Stage. It was a memorable evening for all of us that were there. Thank you for joining us tonight, and here for you now is DJ Cookie and the graduating class of 2020 and the School of Media Arts and Studies.
Celebration.
And I never felt this way before. And I-
Cause that shit done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation.